Now that we have a general understanding of the application we're going to control, it's time to sharpen our tools, or at least install and get the main tool, Automation Builder, ready. Of course, I will leave the link to the software in the description section below the video, but let's be honest, you'll Google it anyway, so why to resist it? The very first result will lead you to the dedicated Automation Builder page on ABB's website. Under the section Latest Automation Builder Version, you'll find download links to 32 and 64-bit installation packages. We recommend using the last one. And release notes, which is, by the way, very useful to understand what have been added or changed in the specific version of the software. While downloading installation package, you might have noticed that the file size doesn't really look like large engineering suite of software. And that's okay. Installer app you have downloaded will contact ABB servers, download needed packages, and install them. Okay, we started the installer, and beside installation of Automation Builder itself, we will see other options. Like we can download all the packages and create an offline installer, or install only additional tools, like IP configuration utility, for example. At this step, you will need to read carefully and license agreement, and then agree to its terms. The next page is probably the most important from the whole installation process. First, we should choose between Basic, Standard, and Premium Edition. On the very same page where we have downloaded Automation Builder Installer, there's a table which breaks down nicely which features are included in each edition of the software. We're going to stick with Basic Edition, which will be more than enough for our purposes. In the tree below, you can put checkboxes on features or functionality you will need. For example, you might want to give some technology preview options a try. Once you're done with your selections, hit Download and Install button. First, installer will download all the needed packages, and then installation process will start. And please keep an eye on the installer window, because sometimes it might need you to click on OK or Next button. Here we go. Installation process is finished and we can start the software. Now, even though we have installed three Basic Edition of Automation Builder, we still need to deal with licensing. If we had purchased software license, that's exactly the place where license number should be inserted to activate it. There's also an option to get 30 days trial license of Premium Edition, but since we have installed Basic Edition, let's select accordingly. In case of purchased licenses, there is an option to bind it either to PC hardware or to special USB dongle. For computers which are not connected to the internet, there is a special offline activation procedure. Once we click Next, License Manager will contact to ABB License Server and get license activated. And now we have Automation Builder activated and can finally start it for good. I know that software installation might seem quite a trivial task to dedicate the whole video to it, but it is a necessary step before we actually hit the ground and start developing control application.